AKA Keep It Real, Live and Living Color, screaming what they do. I'm Live in Color here with the best of the best. Yours truly, the Jimmy. I don't even know the star yet, but today I'm doing her photo shoot. She's a magician, writer, poet, model. I'm just privileged to be able to have this opportunity as a movement. You know what I mean? We here live in Living Color in Tampa, Florida, at the Sheraton Hotel. Got big things going on. Here with Cajun Music, Cajun Videography, Live in Living Color, streaming what he do. Y'all just stay tuned. Y'all can check me out on Facebook. I take this coming, or type in KingLife09@gmail.com. It's just the beginning of the movement, you know, with her, with other KG, it's a whole other up-and-coming, you know, bashing head, you know, takeover movement. Here's what they do. Check. Giving King Life Entertainment, aka Kojak, aka poet, aka photographer, aka promoter, aka realer than real, North Shot, giving me exposure. So y'all check me out. Y'all wanna mess with me, hit me at 941-465-3016 or contact me email kinglife09@gmail.com. Here with Ejima, the introduction, Live and Living Color. Y'all catch up. Catch up. December 10th, Live and Living Color, Pomona, Florida. Phil Mob in concert.
Changes things, but yet my situation is still the same. My mama
raised me to believe that the shedding of Jesus' blood will ultimately save me. But I'm still searching for redemption. There's too many scars I built. Faithfully praying beyond the stars, hoping that God would develop a sensitive ear to my righteous prayer. I ain't gonna lie, it is hard to believe in the unseen when all I come to know is despair. Yeah, my mama raised me to believe that the shedding of Jesus' blood will ultimately save me. But I'm still searching for redemption. What do you know about sending down and repainting your last year bicycle just so you can have something new on Christmas? God, I am calling you. I am crawling to you, asking that you explain these pains and flames I've been made to walk through. Growing up, it was hard for me to ever believe in a dream. I couldn't seem to get past the fact that my reality was infested with deadly posters of hot dogs and poker beans. I've been football stars, turned junkies and fiends. First of the month checks, welfare cheese, free lunches in the summertime and the government projects. And my mama barely made ends meet. Sons of school clad in church hand-me-downs so we looked presentable and neat. There was times we had little or nothing to eat. And when things got so bad, she'll send us next door to borrow simple items like butter, bread, and meat. I swear, my problems are hard like concrete. And late night screams and gunshots made it hard to sleep. And back then, your mama jokes were the way to escape reality because we were all in a state of depression and financially broke. And now that I think about it, maybe this is why the old folks get pissy drunk under the shade tree, and just maybe their childhood scars diminish their vision from being stars. And just maybe their childhood scars is the reminder that the past is real. And just maybe their childhood scars are something they feel still can feel. Escapism became the way that a lot of black people cope. It became our therapeutic antidote. This is what we smoke and don't know why. This is why we get high on our own supply. This is why we are dying to live rather than living to die. God, some things make you laugh, but I swear if you listen to my prayer, it make you wanna cry. Believe in the good book. You tell me I'm a good slave because I didn't kill your ass after all the blows I took. Instead, I turned the other cheek. Afraid to strike back, thought I'll be burned, so I played stupid and meek. And you preach the weak should inherit the earth, and the last should be first. But what about the tormented, rejected, and oppressed? From over here on slave ships, called sweet Jesus, and branded like cattle in our flesh. But God isn't a liar. God isn't a cheater. God used one particular people just to send a message to the whole world and teach him about success, true success. See, success, it is a process. It is a process full of uh-uhs and no's. Obstacles that stand between you and your goals. It is working hard for what you believe you can achieve, like finding the keys to unlock closed doors. Working hard to build your dreams with your bare hands until they're covered with blisters and souls. It's letting God and faithfully letting go. Find the seed of courage planting you and watching it grow from a tiny acorn to a mighty oak tree. And with humility, defeating odds and adversity. Success is going from I can't to I know I can. To being knocked down 9 times, yet I still stand. It is being broke, but ambitious. Learning to cope without aid or assistance. It is finding the discipline to strengthen your patience. Like an orphan awaiting a place to call home. Or the story of David that defeated Goliath with a slingshot in the stone. It is Malcolm X screaming by any means necessary. It is Martin Luther King who had a dream and Obama came to fulfill it screaming, yes we can. It is Harriet Tubman walking miles and miles and miles and miles, barefooted in the name of freedom. It is losing yourself in order to find yourself. It is knowing the difference between the obstacle and the stepping stone. It's the way you use them. And regardless of where you've been and what you know one thing for sure, that God isn't a liar. God isn't a cheater. God used one particular people just to send a message to the whole world and teach them about success, true success. And if he did that, he can also use you. That's it.